Refrigerant is a key component of any refrigeration system. When refrigerant is lost, the system's efficiency decreases and causes components to work harder, resulting in premature failure. To avoid callbacks and additional system issues, it is important to identify and repair refrigerant leaks the first time. Here are some tips to identify system leaks. The first thing you should do is determine what refrigerant you are working with and how much remains in the system. If the system contains an A2L or A3, be sure to handle these refrigerants with extreme care, as improper handling can lead to serious injury or death. If the refrigerant charge is low, certain leak detection methods can be less effective. Start by visually inspecting the system. If you find a leak along the way, know that there could be other leaks, so it is important to inspect the entire system. If you find signs of a leak, it can be helpful to mark the area with a piece of tape or chalk so that you can easily find it again later. Common leak points include flare joints, Schrader valves, pressure relief valves, shutoff and ball valves, service port caps, returned bends on evaporators, condensers, and condensate tray pipework. All mechanical joints and flanges are prone to leaking. Look for oil trails as you visually inspect the system. Oftentimes, what looks like oil is just moisture. You can feel with your fingers to confirm. If water is present in the pan below the evaporator coil, you may be able to see discoloration from the refrigerant oil on the water's surface. Using a flashlight can help you spot any oil. If you see oil, it's likely coming from the coil above. You should also look for corrosion or ice buildup, as these can be an indication of a leak. On the high pressure side of the system, outdoors, there are a few components worth checking for signs of leaks. There may be a leak if the capillary tubes on the suction line have oil on them, the accumulator has rust around the base, or if the service valves have oil on them, unless the system was serviced recently. Removing the gauge set can often leave oil behind. Once you have visually inspected the entire system, use an electronic refrigerant leak detector to guide you to the leak source and pinpoint the leak location. It is important to understand that most refrigerants are heavier than air, so they tend to settle lower to the ground. To use an electronic leak detector, turn it on and hold it close to the suspected leak area. If a leak is detected, the unit will alarm and provide a visual indication. Before each use, we recommend using a reference leak like TechCheck to confirm that your detector is alarming to refrigerant. Be aware that large refrigerant concentrations can shorten the lifetime of certain sensor technologies, like heated diode or semiconductor. You should be comfortable with how your leak detector operates. Not all detectors function the same or use the same sensor technology. Many electronic detectors zero to the background refrigerant level. So move the detector to clean air once refrigerant is detected to allow the detector to set a clean air baseline. After a few seconds, check the suspect area again to confirm the leak. Some detectors have an adjustable sensitivity, allowing you to pinpoint certain leak sizes. It is often helpful to start in a higher sensitivity. Switch to a lower sensitivity once you have narrowed down the general area of the leak to ignore the lower refrigerant concentrations. Most electronic leak detectors should be serviced periodically. The filter, sensor, and batteries should be changed per the manufacturer's recommendations or as needed. For example, DTEC 3 and DTEC Stratus have infrared sensors that tend to last much longer than other sensor types. Depending on your leak detector sensor technology, you should be aware that certain substances like oils, soaps, sealants, solvents, and even pipe insulation can cause false alarms. Infrared sensors have fewer cross sensitivities and won't alarm to common causes of false alarms, but they'll still react with alcohols. Be careful not to contaminate the detector with oil or water, as these can damage the internal components. Soap solution is another way you can confirm the presence of a leak, but it can be difficult or impossible to leak check certain components, like evaporator fins. Certain soap solutions can cause your electronic leak detector to alarm or mask a leak temporarily. So we recommend using your electronic detector first and then confirm with soap solution after. Spray lightly to avoid creating bubbles that could be caused by aggressive spraying. Be aware that it can take up to 20 minutes for a bubble to form for small leaks. Small leaks can also form a foamy bubble cluster, often referred to as cocooning. If you're having trouble locating a leak, here are some alternative leak checking methods that may help locate that hard-to-find leak. You can pressurize the system with forming gas and use a combustible gas leak detector, like GasMate, to identify any leaks. Alternatively, you can pressurize the system with nitrogen and listen for the leak with an ultrasonic leak detector like Whisper. Make sure to recover any remaining refrigerant charge before adding forming gas or nitrogen into the system. Observing vacuum decay is a quick, non-destructive way to gauge the tightness of your system. Pull a vacuum on the system and observe the system pressure. If the system pressure falls by a significant amount in a short amount of time, that is a good indication that there is a leak or multiple somewhere in the system. We hope you learned something new from this video. Contact our leak detection experts with any questions or if you need assistance with your INFICON products.